Hey, welcome back. Happy Friday. First 4-day practice week in probably like a month-ish now, which is nice. Don't feel terrible, but I do feel a little tired. Starting on high bar today, I've already warmed up, done all my pre-strength. The goal for today is just to work on tkatchevs on high bar, breaking some grips because these ones are slippery. And I don't like feeling slippery on high bar because I'm already scared of high bar in the first place. Gonna warm up with some taps, might try and change a couple things. I've been brainstorming some ideas for how to make it a little more powerful. We'll see if I can apply it and go from there. Tkatchev attempt number one. Main focus is when I throw, I want it to be with straight arms so it doesn't pull me over the bar too fast.
Got this. Nice.
Huge. Oh. That first tkatchev always kind of stings the shoulders. Funny part is though, the last however many days I've done them, it hasn't always been the same shoulder, I don't think. Today it's the left one, and I'd like to say more often than not it's the left one, but I know there was a day or two where I kind of felt it on the right. Like I've said before in previous vlogs, there's nothing quite like actually throwing for a tkatchev to like kind of break up scar tissue in my shoulder. So I wasn't planning to do three giants. I took the extra one because as I was finishing the second one, it felt a little too stalled and I didn't want that to mess up my timing. So I took one extra giant to try and speed it up a hair. So it helped me with the tap or just helped it feel more normal. Wasn't planning to do that, but it's nice to know that if I really need to, I can take another giant and it's not gonna mess with me. All right, last one, I was thinking too much about the actual throw and catch, I guess, and I forgot about the tap. So I did more in my hips on the way down and less in my shoulders. So it tapped a little later, which made me react later in the front, which is why it drifted. I need to mainly focus on using my shoulders to tap at the right time, and the rest of it should take care of itself.
Nice.
Just going like that. Last one again, I did a little too much of my hips, not enough of my shoulders, but I waited too long to start the push away, which is why the tap kind of happened below bar height. Ideally, I want to feel like two bounces and then I react to tap. And I think I waited until like I made sure I had two and then started the push. And by then it was too late, especially for this to get a really good turnover and be strong when I catch instead of kind of catching on the way down. I have to scare myself to go a little bit earlier. So it's easier to react quicker in the front. I guess I kind of freaked out when I caught it, knowing that it was like a good opportunity to go for it. And all I was focusing on was just getting over the bar. Obviously it wasn't very high and I did this still, but I got over the bar. And that's something I've never even done from bounce tap before. So that was kind of cool. I just watched it back. It actually looked better than I expected compared to how I used to do it when I used to do the pullover tap or the Chinese tap. It's already better than that. And that was my first attempt. So that's cool. But watching it back, I can see that when I'm turning over, I'm looking at the bar. And then once I know my hands are there, there's a little bit of pressure lost and my elbows kind of bend and my head goes through this way. What I want to focus on is locking my elbows so I can get more power for the second tap, but then picking my head up as well to help me turn over faster for the second one. So I don't just kind of have to do a quick pull and throw just to make the second one over the bar. Because ideally I want to be able to do a pike out of it, or at least just like a really nice straddle like the first one. Because I think if I were to do this properly in theory, just a straddle tkatchev, I should be able to do 3 or 4 or 5 in a row once I understand how to catch the bar and push away and all that, so.
One. Yep.
Whoa.
That was max distance.
Yeah.
Frick. That one I was thinking a little too much about throwing the second one and forgot about the first one. I think I'd rather almost throw like a little too early to make sure I'm on top of the bar. And then trust myself that I'm gonna catch tight, push away, and toe up aggressive enough to do the second one.
Yep. Yes. Nice. Way to go.
Woo!
It was the first time for everything. I've never done that before from bounce tap. I always had to rely on the speed of Chinese tap just to get the first one to turn over enough and just hope for the best on the second. And that one definitely didn't feel as good as the first one that I threw. Probably because I knew once I put the first tkatchev on the bar, I was like, don't fuck this up. But it's good for today.
God, I was tighter too.
That's annoying.
Nice. Yeah. There you go.
Woo! Let's go!
Arms are a lot better now, finally. Still seem a little bit rushed, but it's not bad. I'm actually able to throw the D-arm in a quarter without thinking about it too much, so I'm starting to think that D-arms are easier than stutzes. This is backwards compared to how I usually feel about them. I think I'm trying too hard just on the regular D-arm. Like, I'm trying to speed up the swing, and that's why it gets thrown off. The D-arm in a quarter, I felt like I was just kind of falling from handstand, and obviously it was better.
Very nice.
Oh my god, I look like I know what I'm doing. I think as soon as I get this one in, I'm picking it up to reach, and I'm not like pushing off. Yeah. Or like pushing that way, because I keep stepping forwards. I don't know why, but the D-arm and a quarter are better than the D-arm at this point. Alright, I would just like to make maybe one or two more of these, and then I'm not going to ruin my day with stutzes, because I don't think I have the mental strength for that. And I'm going to try with some three-quarter D-arms in preparation for Makuts, just to see how they are. Yeah, I'm definitely getting comfortable leaving it on the inside. I just don't know how to quickly, like, push against it so it stops going that way. Or, this swing is actually fine, but because I'm rushing the quarter, I'm not finishing the pushback to help my left shoulder stay on top.
Like, such a little off angle.
Yeah, I like that my toes are on the inside, but it's quickly going this way. And I think if I have a little more push off the right, it might be easier to transfer the weight. Like, I'll have a little more time to think about pushing it.
That makes sense.
And I think if I do it properly, I should be able to think, okay, grab, push, and then if I want to step back to the middle, I could. Training the D-arms like this, I haven't really done three-quarter unless it's a warm-up for a real D-arm, so I just want to see how they are and not worry about splits. That is weird. Okay, that was definitely way too fast on the way down, and I went back to closing up. I think this one especially, I need to basically just fall from handstand, because if I speed it up at all, I'm definitely gonna bend my knees and just cut it off, and it's gonna be like how I used to do it. This feels very wrong, very wrong. All right, my guy's gotta do P-bars now, so I'm done. Not necessarily upset with the dough, because my shoulders are sore from high bar.
All right, I'm gonna do a little bit of tuck pull double pulls. It shouldn't take too long. And then I'll probably do a little bit of marbles too, but not as much as I was originally planning because my shoulders, they don't hurt, but they definitely are sore from high bar, and I wanna make sure I'm not spending the whole weekend trying to just feel better instead of just recovering normally. Okay, the week's finally over. Today I was trying to not push too much sequence stuff just because it was the end of the week and I was feeling a little bit tired and sore and I didn't want to risk injuring anything more. That's why I was just spending most of my time focusing on one skill or one pass at a time. But overall, I'm pretty happy with the progress this week. Palmo was the only event that I was really struggling with and I wanted to do a little bit more palmos today, but unfortunately I left it towards the end because I wanted to make sure that I got P-bars out of the way first before my guys started training. And then once I finished P-bars, I wanted to go to floor to give my upper body a break. So I left pommel till the end when I was tired. Next week, it'll be a little bit easier to focus more on pommels like I usually do just because we'll be back to a normal schedule. Really, the only thing that's bothering me right now is my shoulder, but that's been kind of irritated all week. So I'm not entirely surprised that it got more sore today after doing all the tkatchevs, but very, very happy that I was able to do the connected tkatchevs because the last time I did it was from Chinese tap. And even when I did it from Chinese tap, I was only able to do it a few times and I didn't really understand how to make it work, I guess. I was just kind of using speed as the answer. And now that I'm doing it from bounce tap, it's forcing me to use my shoulders and do proper technique to make it work. Because if I don't, I'm not going to have enough power or speed to get over the bar. So that's a big step in the right direction. Very happy with that. And I'm hoping I'll be able to add a pike to it soon, maybe play with tkatchev ginger, something like that. Just get creative and play around. But that's it for this week. Word of the day, let's go connection. Plain and simple for that high bar connection. Hope you enjoyed, and I will catch y'all on Monday. Peace.